I think there will be a tremendous amount of development in the next 5 years in VR. So I think we'll see wires disappear. People can use headsets freely without being tethered to a computer. I think we will see tracking improving. So I think the whole body will be tracked and be able to be transferred into a virtual environment.
The social impact will enable people to connect more, and it may mean that you can travel less. So whereas people now, it's all about face-to-face, and meetings are a lot more successful with that face-to-face interaction. I think virtual reality will allow you to have those meetings and those interactions with people without having to travel. So, you know, whereas people are thinking now it's all about creating these rail networks and thinking about how to move people, we should be investing in technology that allows us to have to meet virtually so that we can, a new way of interacting.
I think it's interesting when we consider VR and AR as maybe replacements for the tools we already use. If you look at things like, you know, smartphones and, you know, computers, how we interact with technology and how technology can mediate our lives right now, I think that this is kind of like throwing more into the mix, right? I think we have a glut of amazing technology which can be utilized in just many, many different ways. I'm very interested and invested in seeing where this kind of augmented reality technology can go. I'd love to see what the next ways we interact with computers are. Not only what do they show us, but what do we show them? How do we show them our problems? And how do we get computers to understand us and the world as we humans perceive it?
Yeah, I think virtual reality will play a major role in the sort of allied health space, particularly around sort of mental health, the treatment of mental health and other phobias and conditions, and just exposing people to a variety of scenarios, whether it's treating phobias of, you know, spiders or distractions, so that people might be undergoing painful surgery or other procedures. And virtual reality has been shown to sort of distract patients from those. From the pain of some of those procedures. So I think we'll see that allied health will have a lot to benefit from this sort of technology, virtual reality technology.
It's basically the closest thing you get to putting yourself into someone else's shoes. Like, you can really experience it with your own eyes, from a first person perspective.
We've seen the possibility that we can use VR and games in general to train and educate people in a way that is more powerful than we've been able to do before. Whether that's in classroom teaching, or whether that's, you know, video and, you know, audio use. So there's definitely more power here in this medium. We're on the cusp of a range of very interesting potential components that we can use to design new ways that we solve our problems using computers. So I'm excited to explore that. I want to plumb the depths of what we can do with this tech. I want to push it in ways it's not been pushed.